So my brother figured out a way how to, my brother used to get picked off for this. Anybody know what this means? How work hand. I mean, his teeth didn't really help either. And his nappy hair didn't really help either. But them hot water pants was kind of a, they come wrong, it could be a frozen, that's out of the school kind of thing, right? Now, in my school, nobody cared that I rap. I mean, I rap. They'd be like, so? So I was like, this is not gonna come easy. So I met a young man in third grade named Dusty. And Dusty was a really talented dude. Dusty could flip, break dance, rap, sing, and he kind of took to me when all the other kids kind of did. Tell you what I did do in the third grade though, that kind of changed the scope of things. I fought a school bully. That was no mistake, we planned the fight. He was like, I'm New York. I'm like, from New York, right? Looks like I had a fight the whole school game. And we fought. And I don't know if I lose his butt. I'm gonna deal with my butt. I tell you what, I went back to school like this the next day. I really was like, Pablo, went from Jungle Boy to Pablo. Third grade. Let me just take you back. I ain't no tough guy. In New York, straight up, from 5 to 6 years old, I fought at least 3 times a week, straight up. So I was like, fighting with me. It was a hobby, it was kind of dick. You'd beat up your best friend and come back the next day and play army, you know what I mean? So, but Dusty was real cool, and he was like, man, you could dance, man. I was like, you know, he was showing me all these handstands and breakdance and things, and I really couldn't do it, actually. But I realized something that I could do that a lot of my friends couldn't, and that was pop. Now, you know what my yang, so I gotta be careful, because y'all think pop, I mean, get it, girl, get it. No. I mean, right. So Dusty and I started dancing together around the school, after school, and then the end of the year, graduation. Oh, end of the year, talent show thing. Dusty was like, y'all, we should do a dance. Now this is the 80s in Texas. Baby can't help it, okay? Anywhere else might have been different. Houston is closer into a city we had around Baby Camp. A lot of Caribbean people there because the oil, the work for the construction, pipe fitters and all that stuff. So we did this little dance, and I never forget, I hope this video is not sarcastic anymore. I couldn't dance back then either, probably. And, I never forget the dance. I had girls going, oh, that was girls. That was like my cool point. Oh, that was girls. I was like, yeah. I ate my eyeball and it went down my body and it came out and I put it back in. You know, did a little reminder. I never forget. I think I was in the 5th grade by this time. So we did a little dance. And you know what? I'm going to be a dancer for the rest of my life. 5th grade, I was like, I got it, I figured it out. I want to be a dancer. This is it, I'm set. I made it in my mind. My brother wants to be a rapper, I want to be a dancer. Okay? So, I get to middle school, and I'm still doing my little popping the time. And one day my dad came home, and watching me and my homeboys on a little cardboard box popping, my dad stood there after work, a little lunchbox, all covered in black, because he worked as a ball person. Said nothing, went home. I came home that night. My dad said, I found a baseball league for your age. That was a dream come true for me. I wanted to be Reggie Jackson. Michael Jackson, Dr. J, Muhammad Ali. There'd be a lot of things. I had a lot of ambition as a little kid, nerd. So,